Hello, my lovely crafters. I am so happy what I see so far about this diamond painting. Only background and some colors already done in here, mostly darker background I went after first. Here it is. A little bit of dark colors went into her face. There's the beautiful gray beads shading. Here's the black that we did together in the other video. And I have a light pad on so you can see actually where is finished, where is not. Let's see how this is gonna look like if I turn off the light. I don't know if this way is better or not. So far when I'm looking on her face, I think the way the shading done on this picture, she will look really, really realistic. And right now I picked the most beautiful color of the bunch, this one, that we're gonna work together a little bit with you. And that is 3756, and that is umbrella symbol. And we have lots of this symbol in here on a corner and on her face, so obviously her face is going to be kind of like a turquoise color. So why don't we do a little bit together and we'll see how this picture will look like on the end, because on the end of this video I will show you the finished project, because I want to finish this today. So this is how much we have so far. So my plan is to finish this today so you can see this video in full, in two videos, start and finish. Well, let's get started. For this video, I will try, hopefully it's gonna work from my point of view. And let me show you this gorgeous, gorgeous drills. They are so amazing. Very sparkle, look how even this one. I already finished many drills, many colors, and I do have leftovers of each color that I already finished. So that's always good to know. Hopefully you will like this angle. It's super duper not comfortable for me, but I want you to see from my point of view, because when I created video like last night, I was doing black checkerboard. The way I see from this side beads, I put, see how like right on a line, you see how it's straight, right? I'm trying to get to the corner like I teach you before. But when you see video from this side, there's always lines in here, could be not as perfect straight. So when I rewatch in my video, it feels like, well, I teach you to do a diamond painting nice in lines. But then when I watch my video, it's not very nice view. Actually, it's not straight at all. So from this point view, you see exactly how I place my beads, and they are go straight on that bottom line. I don't care about the whole square altogether. For me, it's more important so you can see this from my view, because when we look in a picture later, we see the bottom, like if it's in a wall, we don't see nothing at all. It's gonna be nice and straight. Well, from far, we're not gonna see any flaws that we did not very perfect. But at least for now, I think it's better that you see how I place my beads. I'm trying to get, like I teach you before, and I always do this. If this is square, I go after my left bottom corner of that square. For example, like in on this one corner, I don't know if it's gonna be visible for you behind the other bead, but that's what I'm trying to go to, my left corner and the bottom line. Whatever is happening behind this bead, it will cover with the other bead and we're not gonna see it. So maybe this view will show you better work of mine than the way I usually create my diamond painting. I have to say the quality of this drill's particular color much better than black one. Black one, we have a little bit of those sidings, but I have lots of left, so I pick only the best drills when I did that, and I did not worry how many bed or with the sides sticking into in that tray, because when I drill, obviously you could see those bed drills on the tray, so I just left them there and I keep picking a better and better one, and in the end I have still lots leftovers. And actually I'm gonna show you just the 310 here. There's a big amount of drills still left, so I'm not worried about those a little bit misfortune drills, because we're gonna have enough to finish this nice one. I'm a little bit sticking in here to the canvas because I'm using right now magnifying glass, my lamp, because camera stays in front of me, so I have to sit much further, and to see what I'm doing, I need to use right now my magnifier glass. When I was drilling by myself, I was just trusting my eyes and that's it. I did not use any helper because it's very easy. This canvas is really, really easy going, that's what I would say. Okay, see, when I did not place this one exactly straight, the glue grab hard, so I'm trying to push it and it keeps sliding away. So anyway, I don't want to pull this out now. I will fix it with my next, actually, you know what, I will take it away because it's gonna drive me nuts. I'm just gonna replace it straight there. It's going to be beautiful because of this LED lights that I'm using on my magnifier stand. I keep amazing myself with the sparkles. Oh, love it, love it, love it. Okay. I should put in here, just a minute, I'm gonna put a little bit of the cover because I'm keep sticking to the side. So on a half side where my hand go, I'm gonna put this sheet cover to the sticky part while we work with you on this part of the canvas. So that way I'm not gonna be sticking to it. Okay. And sorry for my rusty voice. I didn't have my coffee today. Obviously, I didn't have nothing today yet. Believe it or not, it's already 2 o'clock. And I didn't even have a glass of water. Just don't want to. So that's my problem. I need to eat a little bit more often. So if you are planning to lose some weight and you don't know how, start to do diamond painting and you will forget about food, about your cravings. That's a good way to lose weight. Okay, you know I'm just being funny. If you're happy with yourself, do what is best for you. Just be a beautiful person on the inside. That's all we need these days, to have more kind people. If you happen to be, I'm really losing my voice. I need to practice that. If you are new to my channel, please consider to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you always know when my video is going live on my channel. I used to upload video every morning in my time, 7:15. Then I switched to 6 in the morning. And now I'm kind of trying to do different time. I just experimenting to see what's the best time for my video to go live. So I'm still experimenting, but I think I will be go into my time again that morning, I think, for me. So that way it's still evening in Europe and different country, but it's not like deep night yet. So if somebody wanna watch, it's not too late yet. And for those who wake up and maybe wanna have some coffee before work and watch video, that will be already uploaded as well. But if you have some suggestion about time and what is the best for me to post for you, please let me know in the comments. I would love to hear your opinion and see what is best to work for you. Such a pretty color. So we're gonna create this checkerboard. As I talk about the black checkerboard that we created, the first one beads, as you can tell, I'm doing very slow because I want to hit exactly line that I want this to be bead as straight as possible. And the second one, you will see how fast we will go, because we just have to grab and place without even thinking. It's the first layer, usually a little bit more difficult because we want to be very, very straight. And to be honest, it's always kind of more fun to create checkerboard when you have lots of the same color instead of placing just in one line. I'm having a fun. I like to see how they look like. It looks kind of beautiful. Maybe a little dizzy for you. I hope not. I hope I don't make your head spin by looking on this checkerboard. But I love the second part when we're gonna put beads between them and they just snap, snap, snap. Somebody just live for those crunchy noises, how drills snap between each other. Kind of relaxing. Do you think it's better view for you this way? Let me know. I am not craving to go outside. I'm happy with what I'm doing, and that's it. Sometimes it seems like I'm pushing my drills too hard into the canvas. I really don't. I'm just placing, barely touching the glue. The only thing that I try to force sometimes when I feel like I put drills not as straight as I wanted, so that way I kind of try to twitch and try to push on the bead to get to the right position. So we're working right now on the left bottom corner of the image, and this is kind of like a shoulder of Marilyn Monroe. Alright, and now let's do some snapping a little bit since we already created this beautiful checkerboard. Let's do placing beads. First line. Let me shake my tray a little bit. And let's do the snappy time. See how much faster we're doing right now? So this is why you kind of increase your speed. If you would do this big patch of the same color one by one lines, it would take you longer. But because now we're just placing them right without even thinking on the empty places, you can tell that it's much faster than I was, oopsie, missed a bit, created the first row. I really need to replace my wax. I did already, but because it's a square drills and sometimes I push harder, the drills go, I mean, wax pushing inside sometimes a little bit too much. What do you think so far? Oh, I just love this kind of drills. First of all, the color is beautiful. Well, it seems on camera almost like white, but it's a gorgeous light turquoise kind of color of the sea. Talking about sea, I'm gonna tell you a funny story. Before I went to a tropical on vacation, I thought that it's hard to believe the ocean could be that kind of beautiful turquoise blue color. So I told my family, oh, come on, they just photoshopped pictures. It's not possible to have this kind of color. So then we went to a trip to Cuba. For the first time, I went to the ocean. And the water was such a beautiful turquoise color. So my family decided to tease me. My husband says, oh, look, it's photoshopped. So we laugh all the time. We see the beautiful colors, nice sunny day when the colors are the best. They keep teasing me every single time how photoshopped water looks beautiful when we swim. So that's a little giggles for you for today. And silly me that I did not believe the water could be that beautiful in real life. I thought it would be like just regular gray water, but the way it's shining up there on a white sandy beach, oh, it's just gorgeous. It looks like real Photoshop. What can I say? Yes, two trips this year close on my behalf and everybody else probably. So we are still hoping that everything go back to normal at least to the end of the summer so we can go on a trip in Canada, like just to see some places in the country where we live, but we never been there. So that's my plan, and hopefully we can do something this year with kids. Yeah, I need the wax. It starts to catch a little. Maybe I should keep my tray from this side. Making a shadow. Making a shadow. Yeah, I need the wax for a second. Just a minute. I did refill it, but it's go very fast out. So I have my handy wax from Dreamer Design on container. Now it's easy, but the only thing, since you refill and push in a drill, you see the wax is coming out from the sides of the pen. So you have to kind of wipe it. And sorry for the noises of my phone. It's my lovely husband asking if I want a coffee. So let me finish this little tiny piece in here, and I will continue with you in few minutes, and we will see what we created here so far. And I need to wipe my wax again. See, that's the beauty when you start a new wax, just keep pushing out of the pan. Let me chat to my husband and I will get back to you as soon as possible. So here's this little corner that we just created with you. Usually white colors, you can see more of the gaps if they have. But now remember that you are very, very close right now to the canvas. And it's still barely, it's not, it's like 100% perfect straight, like obviously I'm not that perfect, but it's good enough. It have a little bit, maybe some gap in a little bit, but it's not much at all. And usually I expect on white colors to see them more, because we can see more of the background seeping through instead of like black. We cannot see this very much till we put lights from the light, when we put lights that we can see kind of more, even on a black later, well, still kind of good looking. So this is the bottom of her shoulder, I guess, in here, or maybe that's her fur kind of look like. I don't know. I think that's what we did right now. It's possible this little piece, I think. It's not her skin, I think. Yeah, definitely. That's a fur, that's her clothes in this color. So I'm gonna put now this color on her face because we have same symbol on her face, because I really wanna see her face, how she look like first. So I'm gonna create face right now by myself, at least to put like first layer of the checkerboard, because it's gonna be not comfortable for me to reach out together, drill with you, as camera would be, I will have to change position of the camera, unless we can still work together on the bottom part right now. If you don't mind, let's do that maybe. We can zoom close. Let me figure out what I wanna do. I changed my mind. We are going to do a little bit more in here on the bottom of the canvas, because when I look on a time, I don't have too much peaceful time, because my family will be home shortly and I need to start cook dinner. So right now when it's peaceful in here, let's just do a little bit more together, and then by myself I can do some progress later when everybody doing their own thing in here, and sometime later in the evening when I finish this canvas, then we definitely will see the finished project in this video, hopefully. Okay, I'm just time from time need to clean up my pen from wax sticking out. This umbrella European diamond painting canvases always have interesting symbols, not like the one that coming from China. Here, like thumbs up, some hearts, umbrellas, could be some car. So it's always interesting symbol, not like the one we used to from China that's come. So it's fun to work and see some funky symbol. There. Sometimes when wax sticking to the bead, I'm just like kind of tap lightly and the wax go back into the pen instead of staying. See, like in here on the bead, I'm trying to unstick little top and I see a little bit in here, and then I just wipe on my, oh, we hit the lamp, wipe on my hand. That's what happened with fresh wax, always pushing away. After I finish this diamond painting, I will be cross stitching a little bit. it's so nice to get back to cross stitching, and it's really joy to work and do on my ballerina. I really love my ballerina. It's really easy to stitch because it's lots of, most of the stitching is like a half stitch, so it's go fast. That's a big corner in here in one color. Just get comfortable. I can do this. Sorry if you hear some noises in the background. My little girl trying to be very, very quiet because she hear me recording video. So she trying to tiptoe up there. What should I tell you? What kind of story should we talk about? I need to pick some like subject for my next video or something, so we know what we're talking about. Usually I'm just do spontaneous. I never have a plan. That's why I think it's more fun, because I don't know when I shoot video what I'm gonna talk about, because it's not something really to teach you. You know already everything about diamond painting if you are doing this for quite a bit, but there's always something new that kind of can get into my head and I want to share. All this diamond painting that I have in my stash, I can be in quarantine for years and not to worry go outside. How about you? I know some of your collectors up there as well. We don't have to worry. And I see the crafters all over Facebook keep talking about that, you know. We don't worry about quarantine, because if you are doing some kind of craft, you always can be busy with something. Your hands never stop. For example, me, I can't just watch TV and do nothing. Oh no, my hands need to do something. If I can't have enough light to do maybe diamond painting, then I need to do maybe cross stitching. If I can cross stitch, I will figure out do something maybe with beads. And just, I can't, a long time ago when I was doing lots of paper craft, and my girl Catherine would say, okay, let's watch movie together, I would grab a punch in my hands, you know, craft punch, and I would punch a whole bunch of flowers out of paper, and then I would sit, create some flowers for my cards or layout pages. There's always something I have to do, otherwise I feel like I'm wasting the time just to stare on TV and watch TV. I have to do some stuff. And you know, because there's no sports right now playing, everything is shut down, no sports allowed to play. So you know what my husband doing? He's watching sports like from years ago. He's rewatching some hockey or WrestleMania from years ago. Oh my God, I was laughing hard when I saw this. I said, oh, you found actually hockey that is full ring of people, like fans? Where is that? He say, oh no, that's an old game. I start laugh. Poor thing, because hockey for him, sports, it's a number one hobby that he have. And now he can't watch anything. So he's like really stuck. And he don't have anything else hobby besides like, you know, sports. So he's bored. He, you know, you can't keep him in a house because he would go cuckoo without doing anything, nothing. So yeah, me, it doesn't bother. I can stay home and I always find something to do. And for those who don't have love for craft, I was gonna create interesting video how you can do your chores around house. If someone don't like to do chores, there's some kind of game that will make it interesting for you and your kids. I just need to find one subject and I will do that video. Need to entertain yourself somehow, even if it's a chores. But it could be made interesting in these days. Right, I'm gonna fill in the spaces in here. And I have to go make a dinner. Easy dinner today. Homemade hamburgers. At least now we eat at home more than out. That's a good thing. All right, let me create this line to the end. And then I will see you with a little bit more progress of this canvas. I really would love to start on her face, to see her face and close. We can finish later. Right there. Another piece done. And let's see one more time of this gorgeous sparkles that we created. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, my lovelies, I will see you shortly in just a few seconds. Let's switch some colors into the gray and I will try to see if I can work a little bit with that replacer in here. As much as I wanted to finish this last night, I didn't finish, didn't have enough time. I was a little bit busy. So I really want this video go live today. Let's just use, I have left very, very little. And I think so far I look, last night when I was doing it, looks really good. I think for the picture, this size, it's only 20 by 30. A diamond painting look beautiful. Okay, replacer doesn't work very well, I guess. See how tight those gems go. I would finish if I would work with three placer yesterday, but I work only with one placer. And then I figure out, well, am I okay with this particular canvas to work with three placer, because looks like, you know, gems go together very tight. So there's not much gap, and even if I use my three placer, and I think you can see this in here right now as I place. Not sure how much could you can see. Let's see if we can get a little bit more close. There's only a few colors left that I didn't place yet. Her face looks amazing. We can see this on the end of the video. Stay patient, or if you don't like chit chat, you can look for the way on the end of the video. Links to the canvas, as always, will be under in the description box. Okay, we're done. Let's finish this one, and then I'm gonna show you the finished canvas. A little bit more of this one. There is some very beautiful one more color with like a turquoise. Let me check this bag in here. Oh, very similar to the other ones. I think it's gonna be go somewhere on the face. Alright, I'm ready now to see the whole canvas finished. So I just need like a little bit time to finish, and then we will have the whole beauty. Alright, see you then. Ladies and gentlemen, we are finished. Yay! I'm so happy, I'm so thrilled. I love the way this diamond painting looks. So let's do first thing is first. I'm gonna show you that every color left over, some more, some less, depends how many drills was to begin with in this. Some of them just like a few, because they were like, you know, in some thing it was like very, very little tiny bits, so left like, you know, some like this, but it's still left, right? Still leftovers. Now I did roll on a hard surface, not on this cushiony mat that I have on my table. On a hard surface I roll, and actually three beads got into the place that I missed somehow, didn't push hard enough. So it's always good to have any roller. If you don't have a crafty roller, use a kitchen one that you're using for your rolling dough, stuff like that. Now, here it is. I'm gonna show you, and she look fantastic. I think you all will be agree with me that this diamond painting looks so good. It's almost like natural picture. Even canvas are such a tiny canvas. It's 20 by 30 centimeters. But look at the details. Right now, this picture are so close to the camera. And look at details. You can see her hair, her curls. You can see her earrings. The only thing I think her iconic birthmark on the cheek. It kind of like it's in here. Maybe needed a little tiny, like a darker bead. I don't know if I should replace it or not. But I mean, look at this original picture and this one. Isn't it beautiful shading? I said the shading on this pictures is gorgeous. For me, she probably wouldn't be as beautiful in the colorful drills that she is in black and white. And we say black and white, and there is not really white shades in here. It's all kind of cream, grays, and even in here, the gray. Okay, let me zoom to the table so we can have better light. Those drills in here, it's almost like it's a gray, but gray bluish kind of color. And you wouldn't think that you actually could use this color for this black and white design. But also there is like this light turquoise that creates such a beautiful shade. And of course the drills are very, very shiny. And let me show you from far. From far she looks like just like a picture. And if we wiggle a little bit of light to see all this sparkles. Drills are very sparkly. And as I say, some drills have a little bit of those edges. Not too many, but I managed to have enough of them to place on a canvas the good one drills without picking the bad ones. Black drills, look how shiny that corner is, gorgeous. And I just cannot have enough how beautiful the details on her in such a little picture. Can you imagine a picture like this at least like 40 by 50 or stuff like that? That would be like just amazing. Those drills that we place in here on the bottom, those turquoise, remember? And the shading in here in those brown a little bit create, looks like a fur. Look at that, looks like a fur. And I was wondering how those earrings will look like, but look at this. She has this dangling long earring, and I think we can see them very well. Her eyes, lashes, looks just like on a picture. Even I'm looking at from close, from the camera always looks so much more better. But even close up, it's not as pixelated as I thought it would be. I love how her, this curl look like in here, or look at the separation of the hair. It's stunning. I don't have to say, I think you can see with your own eyes that it is a beautiful, beautiful diamond painting in this such a small size, and it looks fantastic. So I'm really, really pleased. I'm so happy I have Marilyn Monroe now in my collection, and I don't think I want her image in colorful beads. I don't know. Because this for me is just perfect, just the way I always think of her image. Gorgeous hairdo, beautiful facial expression. I love it. So I thank you so much who was with me all this time, drill with me. And I wish you all have a good day. Let me even bring you more a little bit close. I have my coffee on the table. And now my other project that I planned for 2020 is finished, and I cannot be happy more than enough with this outcome. So please tell me in the comments, what do you think about this finished diamond painting? I think this is definitely something I can recommend because it's gorgeous. I love Marilyn Monroe. If you love this awesome icon of, you know, celebrity, I think you should have her because this image is gorgeous. So thank you very much. Don't forget to subscribe on our way when you go if you are new to my channel, and I will see you in my next episode.